We are crossing a flowering meadow in the Swiss interior to film an exceptionally growing site. Here, Ruedi Fürst discovered a small lake with a population of the waterwheel plant Aldrovanda vesiculosa. This rootless and free-floating carnivore is a member of the sundew family, and just like the Venus flytrap, it develops rapid closing snap traps. Irmgard and myself are enthusiastic because we find the unusual plants for the first time in their natural environment. Aldrovanda occurs worldwide in the warmer regions, but it is a rare species. Due to the increasing water pollution and the destruction of wet environments, its number is permanently reduced. At regular intervals, 6 traps at a time are arranged like a wheel along the rootless shoot. Just like a number of small Venus flytrap rosettes, put up to one behind the other along an axis. The only 5 mm big snap traps develop more trigger hairs to function, and as an adaptation to the living underwater, they show some differences compared with the Venus flytrap. Actually, in principle, the function of the snap traps is identical. Here, Aldrovanda caught successfully a mosquito larvae. If only for that reason, the plant can be described as quite helpful for human beings. Bigger animals, like this caddisfly, are not endangered. An interesting lecture on the cultivation of Aldrovanda did we videotape at the 4th ICPS World Conference in Tokyo. So please enjoy Douglas Darnowski, at that time working at the Washington College, USA, and his report on the waterwheel plant.
Hopefully, if we have some more space, we could use a little larger plant, something like that. And Aldrovanda, also like the Venus flytrap, has a two-stage closing mechanism. That is, it closes quickly on its prey and then slowly shuts tighter and tighter as it goes in to digest its prey. This is the cultures that we use. This is a standard sort of aquarium you can buy in the United States. It's about 20 liters in size. We put in the bottom about 5 centimeters deep of garden soil, so this is not enriched with a lot of sphagnum moss. This is just plain high clay soil. And then we cover it with about 15 centimeters of tap water. And this tap water, you may be able to see the spots on the glass. This tap water is got some divalent cations in it. It's not very hard water, but it's moderately hard water. So this is something you might say, this doesn't sound like Aldrovanda or any other carnivorous plant's going to like it. But what seems to work very well is if you throw in a couple of water hyacinths, Icornia. You throw in a couple of water hyacinths, it seems to condition the water very well. Whatever nutrients come from the soil, it balances it out. You throw in here a couple of Aldrovandas, and you get tremendous growth of them when it's in warm weather. I've seen setups like this where you will grow, you start with 3 or 4 plants of Aldrovanda, and in a month of warm weather you can have 40 or 50 of them. With freshwater shrimp, you see here the eye and a couple of eggs on this female that's sitting on a back of an Aldrovanda trap. Also, another organism we see lots of when we study bladder warts in our area, copepods, another little crustacean. Again, there's the eye. Amphipods. Now, those first two I showed you are perhaps a millimeter long, maybe a little bit more, maybe a little looked at snails. Here we have a baby snail, no more than a few millimeters long. I should also mention sort of in where I got my materials. I have this small artificial pond in my backyard, which acts very much like those tanks. That is, it has the garden soil in the bottom of it, and you get this mixture of materials in which you find very healthy Aldrovandas with the cyanobacteria and all the other organisms.